talked about, something about it that's deeply sad. I think it is that, I really think it is that they don't think, each of them as individuals, I think they don't think anyone cares about them. They have their suffering, but no one, it's not notable. And so I think part of the reason that they're listening to the lectures is because I notice.
Well, another thing that I need to add to my answer to you is that we need people like you to communicate the basics, because when they come in here, you can understand what I'm talking about. They won't understand necessarily, you know. Maybe they have to go through a time of preparation before they can come and feel what's happening here.
Right.
Okay? Because they've got to get back to that, you know, baby state. Unless you be like children, you never enter into the kingdom. Okay? Because our intellect, inside, gets in the way, the complexity.
That's what it's like talking to Sam Harris. So I'm going to talk to him three times this summer. Twice in Vancouver, four times, so twice in Vancouver, once in New York, once in Dublin. He's a good representative of the intellect. He's very smart. Yeah. And he does things A, B, C, D, right? That's how it works. It's never the whole picture. It's this first, then this, then this, then this. It's hard for me to talk to him because he can't play, as far as I can tell. He can't sit back and see the picture.
Yeah.
And so we say, well, it's part of the picture. You can't make a picture of parts.
Well, that's what lawyers do. They speak like that.
The Pharisees.
That's right.
Right.
So look.
See, also Harris, I think, thinks that he can live by rules.
Yes.
So I think about this is, it's a funny thing, because this is something that's just occurred to me. I'm talking to my brother-in-law, and he's a remarkable person.
Right.
He invented the chip in the iPhone. And he's built the world's first 64-bit computer. He's a real genius. And we're talking about rule governed systems.
Yep.
No. Even the computational systems can't do complex things by lists of rules. It's not possible. So the AI systems, the neural network systems, they learn by experience, but no one knows how they learn. We don't know what their cognitive architecture is. We get output, but no one knows what's inside the black box. We're talking about the possibility that the fundamental cognitive architecture of human beings is based in stories and not in lists of rules, which is also something. And that fits very well with the use of parables, for example.
Yes.
The New Testament, the fact that the entire biblical corpus is nothing but stories. His idea was that a story was somehow specific enough to be useful as a guide, but general enough so that it could apply to all sorts of different situations.
Yeah.
And so, what Harris doesn't understand, Harris thinks the fundamental cognitive architecture is listen to rules, but a bit like the Ten Commandments. And then I think there's an analogy between that. I mean, Christ said that he came to fulfill the law and the prophets, right?
But the rules are
important. Definitely.
You cannot build a structure without suffering.
Right.
And the rules are
scaffold. Yeah, right. Yeah. Yes.
And then when the building is finished, you
tear it up.
Right. So that's why St. Paul says that the law was a teacher of Christ.
Right.
Yes. Prepared. Because, you know, if you begin to limit yourself, you're limiting that ego.
Nietzsche said the same thing about the Catholic influence on Europe, was that it forced the European mind, that was his comment, it forced the European mind to interpret everything under a particular rubric and discipline it as a consequence.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. It has been.
Do you have some water?
Yes.